Warm greetings on behalf of Bharat Institute of Higher Education and Research. So the video which you are going to see is for the paper Technical English, and the course code is U20LEH J01. And let me introduce myself before we start the topic. I'm Dr. Rajakumari R, working as an assistant professor in the Department of English at Bharat Institute of Science and Technology, BIHR. And the topic which we are going to see today is on prepositions. Now, what is a preposition? So before we see in depth about what the preposition is and what are the types of preposition, let me make you clear of how this preposition plays a major role when we frame sentences. Now, when we see the word preposition, what is the exact meaning of this preposition? Now, when we divide this word into syllables, we divide it as preposition. Pre, what is pre? Pre means before. Now, prepositions are words which we place either before a noun or before a pronoun. Now, when we say noun or a pronoun, what are these nouns and what are these pronouns? And what are these prepositions? Now, I hope all of you would have come under parts of speech. Now, how many parts of speech are there in English? There are 8 parts of speech, and preposition is one among those 8 parts of speech. Now, let me list out the parts of speech: noun, verb, adjective, adverb, preposition, pronoun, conjunction, and interjections. Now, these noun, pronoun, and prepositions comes under parts of speech. Now, what is this role of preposition in a sentence? As I told you, a preposition is a word which is placed before a noun or a pronoun. Now, where is the actual place the prepositions are placed? Before. That is what I told you, pre. Pre means before. Now, preposition, let's take an example. I placed a notebook on the table. Now, what is the preposition used in this sentence? On. I placed a notebook on the table. Now, on is a preposition which is used in this sentence, and the place where this on is placed in the sentence is before the noun. As I told you, prepositions are words which is placed before a noun or a pronoun. Now, what is a noun? Noun is a word which means a person, a place, or thing. Let me repeat. A noun is a word which names a person or a place or a thing. And what are pronouns? Pronouns are words that replaces a noun. Now, as I told you, nouns are words which means a person, place, and things. Now, table is a noun. I is a noun. I is a pronoun and table is a noun. It's a common noun. Did you understand? Now, prepositions are words which is placed either before a noun or before a pronoun. Now, when there is no preposition in a sentence, the sentence will be insensible. It will be meaningless. Let me repeat the sentence. I placed a notebook on the table. Do you have any sense in the sentence? It is insensible, right? So when there is no preposition in a sentence, the sentence will be dismantled. The sentence will be hanging. It will not give you a proper meaning. Did you understand? Now let us see in depth of what actual meaning of the preposition is, actual definition of a preposition in the further slides. Now, meaning of preposition. Preposition are words which tells us the position of something in relation to another. Now, position of something in relation to another. It will tell you the position of a noun or a pronoun comparing to the another. So, this is the actual definition of a preposition. Now, let us define in a grammatical way. A preposition is a word which is placed before a noun or a pronoun to show its relationship with something else in the sentence. This is the grammatical definition of a preposition. Now, how are these prepositions classified into different kinds? Prepositions are majorly divided into three, as all of us know. Preposition of time, preposition of place, and preposition of moment. Now, these are the three different kinds of preposition divided on the base of their use in sentences. Now, the preposition are further have four different types based on their construction in a sentence. Now, what are they? Simple preposition, double preposition, compound preposition, and participle preposition. Now, prepositions are classified into two categories, one based on their use in a sentence and the other based on their construction in a sentence. Now, based on their use in a sentence, it is classified into three, as I mentioned before, preposition of time, preposition of place, and preposition of moment. Now, based on the construction in a sentence, it is classified into four types: simple preposition, double preposition, compound preposition, and participle preposition. Now, based on the sentence, as we have discussed, it is classified into three, as all of you can see in the slide: preposition of place, preposition of time, and preposition of moment. Let us see one by one what those categories are. Preposition of place. Now, how can one define prepositions of place? Preposition of place refers to those prepositions which can be used to show where something is located. Now, if you get the answer for a sentence where, that is the preposition of place. For example, I went to the library, which is in the second floor of the main block. Now, where is the library actually? It is in the second floor. So that in there refers to the location of where the library is. So prepositions of place actually used to show where something is located. Now, what are the list of prepositions of place? Above, up, after, on, before, against, by, behind, below, along, near, down, in, at, across, inside, between, and over. Now, these are all the list of prepositions which one will be using to refer prepositions of place. Let us see some example how those list of prepositions are used in a sentence. Now look at the slide and the examples which is there. The aeroplane is flying above the clouds. Now in the first example, where is actually the aeroplane flying? So it shows the location. Above is the location above the clouds. So above refers to the location of where exactly the aeroplane is in the sky. Now look at the second example. The dog buried the bone under the ground. Now the dog buried the bone. Where is it burying? it is under the ground. So it shows the location of where the dog is burying the bone. Now look at the third one. Our house is at the end of the street. Now where is our house located? Actually, at the end. Now off is also a preposition. So there is two reference here of prepositions of place. It is not that at alone is a preposition of place. At is actually refers the place, and off is also refers the place. That is, at the end there is a street and there our house is located. So at, off, both are prepositions here in the third sentence. Now look at the fourth example. The cat ran across the road. So it is not either towards or against. It is running across. So across is a preposition of place here. Now the second type of preposition, when we talk about preposition sentence, when it places in a sentence, is prepositions of time. I think the term itself tells us the time reference, the occurrence of an incident, especially here refers the timing. Now let us see the definition. A preposition of time helps to link the noun or pronoun with a time value. So as all of us know, prepositions are normally placed before a noun or a pronoun. So when it is placed, those prepositions of time refers the time value of the subject or a pronoun. So it functions as an indicator as to what point of time an event occur. Now let us see the list of prepositions of time. List of prepositions of time are about, before, for, by, around, in, ago, at, past, since, to, on, after, until, between, and during. Now these are all the list of prepositions which one uses in a sentence to refer specially an action occurrence which talks about the time. Now let's see some examples. The train is about an hour late. So how long is the train late? It is about 1 hour. So it is not, we are not accurate about the timing. We say like about 1 hour. So about here refers the occurrence of an event when the train will reach the station. Did you understand? Now look at the second example. The classes begins at 8 o'clock. Now when does the class begin? It begins at 8 o'clock. So here too, there is a reference of time. So it talks about when the class actually begins. Now look at the third example. The my birthday falls on Wednesday. So when is my birthday? It is on Wednesday. It is not on Tuesday or it is not on Saturday. So here, time reference is accurate. So we are using on. Look at the words, no? About, at, on. So all these are list of prepositions which talks about time occurrence in a sentence. That is why it is called as prepositions of time. Now let us see the last example. India has been independent since 1947. So whenever we use since, no, an action which would have started in the past and still it will be continuing. So in these cases, we will be using since, and of course here, since here is noted as a preposition. Now look at the example. India has been independent. So how long have you been independent? It is since 1947. The moment we got the freedom, the moment we got the freedom in the year 1947, from that day onwards till today and in future, we will be independent. So that is the actual meaning. So about, at, on, since, and all these are the words of time reference, that is prepositions of time. Now the third type is prepositions of movement. Now what is a prepositions of movement? A preposition of movement is used to show movement to or from a place. So So when an action is occurring, whether it is from the place or whether it is towards the place, let us see some list of preposition. Down, past, into, behind, up, onto, through, off, over, on, across, at, by, for, after, and towards. Now let's see how those words are used in some sentences. Here are some examples. Prepositions of moment. The cat has climbed up a tree. Now actually, where is the cat climbing? Look at the sentence. The cat has climbed up a tree. It is climbing upward and not downward. To be understood. So as we have seen the definition, prepositions of moment are something which is from or to a place. Did you understand? Now look at the second example. The children got off the bus. Got off, O-double-S. What does it mean? Got off is getting down from the bus. Did you understood? So it shows the movement of an action, how the children are getting down from the bus. Whether they are getting down or getting in. Did you understand? Now look at the third example. She ran along the pavement. So along is a reference here of a type preposition of moment. Now look at the fourth one. The bus goes towards the market. It is not from the market the bus coming. The bus is going towards the market. So either from or to. If you see these references in a sentence, those references are prepositions of movement. Now these are the three types which we, when we talk about sentence. Now look at this slide. Based on the construction of preposition themselves, the preposition are further classified into four different kinds. Let me list out: simple preposition, double preposition, compound prepositions, and participle preposition. So the following slides which we are going to see will be about the definition of them and the list of preposition which comes under those categories and few examples to make you people understand in a simple way. Simple preposition. Now what is a simple preposition? Look at the word simple. So often we use certain prepositions without knowing. Those are all called a simple preposition. It consists of only one word. Okay. Preposition that consists of one word and are very simple to understand and use. So it is like take it for granted. So there are certain prepositions which we use very simply. We will not find difficult to use those prepositions in a sentence. Those are all called a simple preposition and it contains only one word. So these are the most basic prepositions and are used frequently, often by the people. Now let us see the list of prepositions. Simple: above, under, around, through, after, on, before, about, among, behind, along, near, down, in, at, across, between, and over. Now these are all the simple prepositions which is used by an individual very simply and frequently. Now let us see those words in an example. Look at the example in the slide. The paper is on my desk. Now where is the paper? It is on my desk. On here refers what? It talks about the place where actually the paper is. And where is it? It is on my desk. So they are very specific about the place. Now look at the second example. The man was standing under the tree. Now where is the man standing? He is standing under the tree and not above the tree. So here too, under refers to the preposition of place. Now look at the third example. I will meet you near your house at 5 p.m. Now, there are two prepositions used in the sentence, but I have highlighted only one to make you understand in an easier way. I will meet you. Near is a preposition, actually. It is a place, preposition of place. Your house at what time? So here, at refers to the time sequence, 5 p.m. So I will be meeting you near your house at 5 p.m. So there are two prepositions, but near here is used as a preposition of place, and at is used as a preposition of time in the third sentence, third example. Now look at the fourth one. She is currently staying in a hotel. Now she is currently staying where? In a hotel. So in here refers to the preposition of place. Now the second type, which comes under the construction of a preposition, is double preposition. Now what is a double preposition? Double prepositions are two prepositions but are joined to make a whole new one. So what is the meaning actually? What do you mean by joined to make a whole new one? So the words, when you count, it will be two. But meaning wise, when you check, it will stand together to give us a meaning. That is what the definition is. Let me repeat. Double preposition are two word preposition. But when you use it in a sentence, it stands together and give us one single meaning. That is called as double preposition. Now, list of preposition. Look at the list. Inside, as I told you, in is one word and side is one word. Both combined together to give us a meaning that inside is what? In. Okay, outside is what? Out. So out and the side, there are two words combined together to give us one single meaning. Look at the other words. Into, onto, upon, up to. It is actually together you have to read. Up to, within, without, amid. So these are all the double preposition, and let us see how those prepositions are used in a sentence. Now, here are four examples for you in the slide to understand this double preposition. Number one, outside the house lies a beautiful garden. Now, where is the garden actually located? It is outside the house and not inside the house. So here, outside is a preposition which talks about preposition of place. Did you understand? Now look at the second example. It is up to us. So it is within us to decide whether we are going to do or not going to do. It is up to us to find a way out. So it is within us to find a way out. So every individual has to decide. It is up to us. So that is the meaning of up to here. Did you understand? Preposition wise, when we talk about it is a double preposition, two word preposition. But meaning wise, when you take it, it gives you one single meaning. Now look at the third example. The dog jumped onto the bed. The dog is jumping where? Onto the bed. On and towards the bed. Onto. Did you understand? And look at the fourth example. Once upon a time, there lived a king. So upon. Upon is a two word preposition, double preposition, but it gives you one. Once upon a time. Long, long ago, we say, no, that is the meaning of upon here. Once upon a time, there lived a king. So upon is a double preposition here. Now, the third type which comes under the construction of preposition in a sentence is compound preposition. Now, one must understand the major difference between what is double preposition and what is a compound preposition. So before we compare, let me tell you what does this word compound means here. Generally, when I ask you what is the meaning of a compound, one may say that it is a mixture. So what is mixture? More than one. Mixture of two words or three words or four words. Did you understood? That is called as a compound. Now, compound prepositions are also two word preposition. It will not be only two word. It will be more than two word also. Did you understood? Compound is what? It is a combination of two or more word, mixture of two or more words. Now, compound preposition are two word preposition. But look at the second point. Unlike double preposition, compound prepositions are not joined and turned into one word. So what is the meaning of second sentence? Unlike double, what do you mean by it will not be similar? Did you understood? Similar is what? Same. Unlike is what? it is different. So it is not same as double preposition. Compound prepositions are preposition which will not join together. It stands as a single individual word. Did you understood? That is what the red highlighted one, which is in the second sentence, mean. Let me read again. Unlike double preposition, compound prepositions are not joined and turned into one single word. So it is separated and it will not join into one single word. They remain as two different words. Did you understood? Now let us see the list. I think each one of you will be understanding it in a simple way. So now this are the list of compound preposition. Look at the word, no? According to, apart from, close to, because of, far from, next to, rather than, instead of, out of, due to, relating to, in front of. Now look at the words, no, in compound preposition. It is there is a space between those two words, but whereas in the previous type which we have seen, that is double preposition, it is joined together. When we talk about inside, no, inside was together, in and side was together, there was no space between those two. Outside was together, there was no space between those two. Did you understand? Now whereas compound prepositions are preposition which stands as two and more words separately, according to, apart from, but the meaning is simple, same. It stands single as compound preposition stands. Did you understood? Next to. Now let us see these prepositions usage in sentences in some example. Now here are four examples for you in the slide. My car is parked in front of the house. Now look at the word compound preposition. No? There is space between in front of, but the meaning is what? In front of is before. Did you understand? Where is the car parked? Where have I parked my car? In front of the house. Before the house, I have parked my car. That is the meaning of it. Did you understand? Word-wise, it stands separately and there is a space. But meaning-wise, it gives you one single meaning and you cannot interpret yourself as a separate meaning. Did you understood? Look at the second example. Rita was never close to her parents. Close to is what? She is not that close to her parents. There is some distance of Rita from her parents. Now look at the third example. She cannot stay here as of now. So as you know, generally we use it for a cause. Hope all of you know what is the causal and effect expressions are. As is actually a causal expression, but just because of is used with the as, though it is separated, she cannot stay here as of now. It is the reference of time, prepositions of time. Did you understand? Now look at the fourth example. This behavior is far from normal. See, far is also a preposition. It is a preposition of place. From is what? It is a preposition of moment, as we know. Now his behavior is far from is what? It is too far. That is what it means. Far from normal. So he is abnormal. He is not normal. That is the meaning of it. So these are all prepositions called as compound preposition. And the last type which comes under the construction of preposition is participle preposition. So before we see the definition of participle preposition, what does the term means here, participle? I think somehow all of us remember when we were reading verb and all, no? We read V1, V2 and V3. First form, we say present tense. Second form, we say past tense. And third form, we say V3 verb, and which is called as past participle. Now, what is this participle preposition? Participle is a word, a verb which has ing to it. Word which has ing or ed to it. Those are all called as participle. Okay? And participle prepositions here actually has ed and ing with it. Now, let me define you grammatically. Participle prepositions are basically participles used as prepositions in a sentence. Okay. A participle is a verb that ends with en or ed or ing. So a verb which ends with ed or which ends with ing or it ends with en. Hope all of you know regular and irregular verb. When we talk about V1, V2, V3 for a irregular word, eat, ate, eaten. Did you understand? that is called as irregular verbs. Yes or no? Now, when we talk about regular verbs, play, played, played. So even in V3, we will be using ED. So here we are not talking about verb. Here we are talking about participle preposition. So participle prepositions are words which ends with EN or ED or ING. Now let us see some list of participle preposition. Look at the words in the slide. Concerning, during, excluding, given. I told you, no, it ends with ing, en, or sometimes with ed too. There are some more words here. Following, failing, respected. Look at this word. It ends with ed. Provided, pending, considering, notwithstanding, including. So all these words are called as participle preposition. So you can easily identify this participle preposition in a sentence. A word which ends with ed or en or ing. So those prepositions are called as participle preposition. Let us see some examples how those participle prepositions are used in sentences. Now here are some examples in the slide for you. Look at the first one. Everywhere my father went, his dog was following him. So you need not look at this as a verb. This is called as a participle preposition here. So there is one more word like everywhere. Everywhere my father went, his dog was following him. So this is called as a participle preposition in the sentence. Now look at the second one. Ram is always curious about anything concerning Shyam. So concerning Shyam, so comparing Shyam, Ram is always curious about anything. So Shyam is not that curious as Ram. That is the meaning of this sentence. Did you understood? So concerning here stands as a participle preposition. Now look at the last example. Everybody was invited to the function barring small children. So what is the meaning of barring here? What is the meaning of this participle preposition here? Everybody was invited to the function, even those who have children. Even those who have small children. Generally, when we go to certain functions like convocation function and all, strictly they will give you instructions like children are not allowed. There are many such functions like that. So here, barring small children here, those who have small children also are invited to join the function. So that is what the third sentence means. Did you understand? So following, concerning, bearing. So all these are prepositions which comes under participle prepositions. Now, hope all of you would have understood the types of preposition and how prepositions are used in different sentences. So I think everything would have been clear with the class, with the slides which I have provided you. Now, hope even all of you would have understand the importance of preposition, especially when we use in a sentence. So if you use it in a wrong place in a sentence, the meaning of a sentence, it is insensible. So you will not get a full meaning for that sentence, even when you misplace the preposition. Did you understand? So prepositions must always be placed before a noun or a pronoun. So you should know where to place the preposition. That is more important. It is not that just because a teacher is asking you or you yourself have a self-interest in using preposition, you can use in any place as you wish. No, don't do that. Okay? So prepositions are words always placed either before a noun or a pronoun. Now let me repeat again. What is a noun? Nouns are words that names a person. So you will be naming words are called as noun. Did you understand? If you say Bible, that is a noun. If you say toothbrush, that is a noun. If you say ID card, that is a noun. Did you understand? So nouns are words which names a person or even places. If I talk about Chennai, Chennai is a place. So Chennai is a noun. Bombay is a noun. India is a noun. Australia is a noun. Did you understand? It names a places. And even things, as I told you, water bottle, toothbrush, mouse, computer, laptop, anything for that sake. Did you understand? So all these are called as noun. Now, what is a pronoun? Pronoun are words which replaces a noun. Well, how does it replace? So if I say a person's name, if I name a person, okay, let me give you an example, like I'm talking about Ram. So in the first sentence, I'll be saying Ram is a very good person. He is very smart and he is a very good player in football. So how am I using? First, when I was talking about Ram, I was using Ram's name. When I was framing the second sentence, I was using a pronoun replacing Ram. What is the pronoun I was using? He. Did you understood? If it is a girl's name, we will be replacing that noun with the pronoun like she. Okay. So hope all of you know what are pronouns. You, your, they, their. Did you understood? So all these are pronouns. So prepositions here generally are placed before a noun or a pronoun. So please be clear. Okay. And what are the types of preposition we have seen? We have seen two different categories. One is divided based on their use in the sentence. And other is, you know, the major based on their construction. It is divided into four types. And based on their use in a sentence, it is divided into three types. What are the three types based on their use in a sentence? Number one, prepositions of place. Number two, prepositions of time. And number three, prepositions of moment. And based on their construction, it is classified into four. What are they? Simple preposition, double preposition, compound preposition, and participle preposition. So hope the examples and the you know, lecture and the slides which I have provided you are more enough for you to understand the usage of preposition in a sentence by all of you. Thank you.